covering breaking news. A stabbing at a local high school. We'll have a live report. Plus, those grocery store wars heat up in our own backyard with a new Meijer in Greenfield. Rebecca. And we're covering breaking news. Police in Shorewood searching for a possible armed suspect after reports of a robbery or attempted robbery. You're looking live at what's happening right now outside the TCF Bank near Oakland Avenue and Olive Street. The first information out is that the suspect ran away from this location. No sign of a getaway car. But again, this is in the early stages, no more than 2 hours old, this report of an armed suspect possibly. So as new information comes in from Shorewood, we, of course, will bring it to you here on the News at Noon. Also new today, a Kenosha high school dismissed early after police say one student stabbed another. It happened early this morning at Bradford High School on Washington Road in Kenosha. That's where we find CBS 58's Kyle Averman, who's been on the scene since this story broke. Kyle.
Yeah, Michelle, Kenosha police telling us at least one student has been taken into custody. The rest of the students here at Bradford High School were released at 10:30 this morning, about an hour and a half ago, school out for the day. Kenosha police say it was around 8:25 this morning when they were dispatched to the school for a reported stabbing. A Kenosha Police School resource officer was inside and was able to quickly intervene and take the one student into custody. We're also told the weapon that he used was also taken. Kenosha police are not really releasing any more information. They're not telling us the severity of the injuries at this time either, and they say it's too soon to know what sparked the incident. Now, students say they stayed in their classrooms while the rest of the morning went on. Again, they were released around 10:30 this morning. You will hear from both students and parents about this incident coming up on the CBS 58 News at 4. Reporting live in Kenosha, Kyle Averman, CBS 58 News.
Kyle, thank you. A criminal justice expert rails against the way inmate Terrell Thomas was treated before his death in the Milwaukee County Jail. It came during a second day of an inquest where it was learned Thomas slept in a concrete slab in his cell. The medical examiner, as you'll recall, ruled that dehydration caused Terrell Thomas's death 1 year ago behind bars. Correctional officers have already testified that his water had been cut off because he had flooded his cell. But expert Martin Horn told the six-person jury inmates should never be deprived of basic human needs.
I don't see any what they refer to as legitimate penological reason. A term we use in the profession. I don't see any legitimate penological reason to keep a person in these conditions for this period of time.
A psychologist who worked with Thomas also testified this morning, confirming that he had bipolar disorder. We'll have more on that coming up on the CBS 58 News at 4 and 5. A toddler is in serious condition this noon, and Milwaukee police say they believe it was his father who put him in the hospital. The investigation centers around what happened in a home near 36th and Hadley. The victim's grandmother told police it was the father. He's 28 years old, and police are holding him. The child's mother wasn't home at the time it's believed the injuries happened. The grandmother reporting the alleged abuse last night. Police have identified the man pulled from the KK River on Saturday. Witnesses say Miguel Hernandez had been drinking and jumped in for a swim. His body recovered near 4th and Beecher. The man whose manhunt created fear and anxiety throughout Wisconsin in the week leading up to Easter pleads not guilty to federal weapons charges. Joseph Jakubowski is being prosecuted both at the state and federal level. Surveillance video showed him stealing from a gun store in Janesville, and it was a retired teacher from Muskego who found him camping on his Vernon County property, bringing to an end the 10-day search for the man who threatened to shoot up schools. Well, the grocery store war is heating up in our own backyard with the ribbon cutting of the new Meijer Supercenter in Greenfield.
3, 2, 1.
Cut that ribbon.
All right, a lot to celebrate there. The 192,000 square foot facility is centered right off of 60th and Layton. That's across the street from Greenfield High School. Now, this is the second high profile opening. 1 week ago, hot dog chain Portillo's opened in what's called the 84 South development. An exciting time for many in Greenfield looking to build up its profile and commerce. Okay, we've got the final one, the last headliner for Summerfest. Paul Simon will be live in concert Friday, June 30th. CBS 58's Julie Parisi is live from the Summerfest grounds with more. Hello, Julie.
Hey to you, Michelle. Yeah, it is a big year for Summerfest, the 50th edition of Summerfest. In fact, so big for the big gig, they wanted to bring in a big name.
If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal.
call you Betty. Betty, when you call me, you can call me Al.
You may recognize Paul Simon's hit song there, You Can Call Me Al. He'll be playing the American Family Insurance Amphitheater on Friday, June 30th. Rock singer Brandi Carlile will be his special guest. Now, here's a full look at the calendar for Summerfest. Other artists taking the big stage are the Red Hot Chili Peppers, Luke Bryan, and Tom Petty, and the Heartbreakers. Tickets for Paul Simon will go on sale this Friday morning at 10 a.m. For everything you need to know about Summerfest, a full list of performers and ticket information, you can visit our website, cbs58.com. Live at the Summerfest grounds today, I'm Julie Parisi, CBS 58 News.
And Julie, we're not done yet. More headliners for the big gig this noon. We now know who's taken over the Briggs & Stratton big backyard at Summerfest 50.
So honey, I'm good. I can have another, but I probably should not. I got somebody at home, and if I stay, I might not leave alone.
No. Andy Grammer is bringing the fun on July 2nd. Other performers include Josh Stone, Fishbone, and Phil Vassar. Full lineup on our website, cbs58.com. Well, I was looking outside and thinking more like summer. But we're still very much in spring. Meteorologist Rebecca Schold is here now. Hello, Rebecca.
Yeah, and if you don't believe it, take a look at the high temperatures from yesterday. Only 40 in Superior up across far northern Wisconsin. Meanwhile, 60s and 70s more common, and even upper 60s across the Northwoods in places like Rhinelander. So we're doing a little bit better than yesterday's noontime temperature. We're up 5 degrees here in Milwaukee, Waukesha, Watertown. So if we're faring a little bit better right now, we'll probably get just a touch warmer than yesterday's readings. Still that south to southeasterly wind, and it is breezy once again. But the difference today is those dew point levels are up a little bit, so it actually feels a little nicer out there, a little milder today. We still have some cooler spots along the lake. We sit at 63 this hour in Milwaukee, but you've got 68 in West Bend, and then look at all those 70s, even Kenosha sitting at 70 degrees despite that bit of lake breeze. As we spread in some of our lakeshore communities, you can see a collection of 60s to low 70s. Bayview, you are now in the 70s there. We have a cooler 63 here in Milwaukee, and cooler still in Sheboygan, only 58 degrees. But still some sunshine to enjoy. We will start to see more of these clouds filter through as we continue on into the afternoon, but wet weather still holding off back to the west. So dry today, but again, clouds begin to thicken later on. Temperatures in the upper 60s and then 70s inland. Breeze holds up, and again, we're going to track those showers and storm chances for you coming up in your ready weather.
All right, we'll see you then, Rebecca. If ever there was a reason for the city of Milwaukee to celebrate, it should be right now. Milwaukee Beer Week runs through Saturday. Establishments across the area giving you unique opportunities to savor the flavor and learn a little something about what makes a good brew. We've got more Inside Suds with CBS 58's Michael Schlesinger and his morning reports from Sugar Maple in Bayview at cbs58.com. It also includes a link to the Beer Week schedule of events. Thursday is do or die for the Bucks. They were trounced by the Raptors last night in Toronto, but Milwaukee gets to return home to the BMO Harris Bradley Center Thursday to even the score, with hopes of going on to take the best of seven series and advance in the NBA playoffs. A game seven would mean returning to Canada to be in a position to go to the next round. Well, he didn't have just a little smoke. Former Packer Sam Shields fined $500 after a package of pot arrived from Colorado, where the recreational use of the drug is legal. Green Bay released him in February after the cornerback spent months on injured reserve. The criminal complaint says officers found the illicit delivery at Shields' Green Bay home. President Trump making a major concession to avoid a government shutdown. But will Democrats still try to make a statement? Here's Craig Boswell.
Craig Boswell, CBS News, the White House.
And sources tell our colleagues at CBS News it's possible lawmakers may have to pass a one-week stopgap bill to keep the government running while they work out the final details. Coming up on the news at noon, a girl gets away from her kidnapper on this block. We'll tell you how she did it. Arkansas carried out the nation's first double execution since 2000. Two convicted murderers, 52-year-old Jack Jones and 46-year-old Marcel Williams, died by lethal injection just hours apart. The men had argued this method was inhumane, but they had lost their legal challenges. At least three other executions are on hold because of other court rulings. A man tries to grab an 8-year-old girl riding on her bike, but she got away. The girl was just steps from her grandmother's house in Chicago on Sunday when the man snuck up behind her and put a plastic bag over her head. The girl kicked the man hard enough so she was able to run away. She was even well enough to go to school on Monday. Two people were killed after a small plane crashed onto a highway in Missouri. Local media reports the plane hit power lines before going down and ending up in a ditch. The crash happened just north of the local Memorial Airport, but it's not clear if that's where the plane was headed. A rash of mishaps locally involving bunnies and yard work has the Humane Society issuing an alert. Check your yard before you begin any work. Five bunnies were accidentally doused with lighter fluid. Another batch narrowly escaped death when their nest was destroyed by a lawnmower. For the record, all are okay and receiving care.
It actually was two blocks from where Aaron Rodgers' family lives in Chico.
Perfect morning for a ride in your classic car. Look what I came across in Jackson Park. This beauty is a 1935 Plymouth. It's the pride and joy of Sergio DeJaro, who tells me not only did his car come from the California neighborhood of the Packers' Aaron Rodgers, it also had a starring role in the John Dillinger gangster film Public Enemy, featuring Johnny Depp, that was filmed all over Wisconsin, including here in Milwaukee. He even showed me this neat feature. I guess there was a shortage on metal, so the top is like rubber. Isn't that fascinating stuff? And it's in great condition, he says, but he doesn't ride it in the winter, only on days like this.
Why doesn't he just make that one giant moonroof on the top?
Are you kidding me? You don't cut into a 35 Plymouth.
Well, okay. All right. Well, it's just a suggestion because in the 10-day coming up.
Okay, we'll see you then, Rebecca. Elton John has canceled some of his Las Vegas shows after contracting a rare bacterial infection. He was even in the hospital after getting sick after a trip to Chile, spending two nights in intensive care. John is now resting at home and expected to make a full recovery. Musician Kenny G gave a surprise performance to passengers on a trip from Los Angeles to Tampa. The Grammy Award winner agreed to play for donations to Delta Airlines' Relay for Life fundraiser. Up next in Money Watch, a popular hair care brand now under fire for a new ad. Plus, how JCPenney is hoping to attract more customers. And lifeguards wanted new summer jobs in Milwaukee County. Hey, welcome back. This one's got a lot of people talking. Shea Moisture, a natural hair products brand with primary ties to the Black community, is apologizing for a recent ad. Their spot opened with a Black woman discussing the difficulties of dealing with her hair. Then it transitioned to two white women. The intended message was break free from hair hate, but loyal customers say they found it insensitive. Shea Moisture has since yanked the ad. On Facebook, it explained our intention was not to disrespect our community. And the company's founder says women of color will remain the focus. JCPenney is partnering with Sephora to add more beauty kiosks and 70 new in-store Sephora locations. The retailer will also hire 800 beauty consultants. The hope is to boost foot traffic and sales. The cosmetic extension rolls out next month and will bring the total Sephora stores inside JCPenney to about 650. Another lawsuit against Uber. In a complaint filed Monday, drivers working for both Uber and its rival Lyft accused the ride-sharing service of using a secret software program to spy on them. The complaint says the goal was to identify who drove for both companies so they could be targeted with incentives to work mostly for Uber. Lifeguards wanted for Milwaukee County Parks. At least 50 strong swimmers are needed for the county's beaches, pools, and aquatic parks. If you want to apply, you must attend a training session, pass a swim test, and be at least 16 by this July. The next lifeguard training session is tonight at 7 at the Pulaski Indoor Pool near 16th and Cleveland. Hey, coming up, we'll have another check of your ready weather forecast. 1224, time for news on the go. A recap of all your top stories happening at noon. A Kenosha high school dismissed early after police say one student stabbed another. Your CBS 58's Kyle Averman.
D8 News.
Milwaukee police have a 28-year-old man in custody as they try to figure out how a toddler was seriously injured at a home near 36th and Hadley. The grandmother reported the abuse last night. The father arrested but not yet charged. We're told the mother was not home at the time. Joseph Jakubowski pleaded not guilty in federal court today. He's being prosecuted at both the federal and state level after surveillance video showed him stealing from a gun store in Janesville and then issuing threats to public officials and schools. The manhunt came to an end just before Easter thanks to an observant property owner in Vernon County who knew something wasn't right about the man living under a tarp without permission on his land. Rebecca?
And the coming days, and that's your CBS 58 News on the go.
Yeah, let's hope that weather's out on the go soon. Hey, keep it here to CBS 58 all afternoon. Coming up at 2, it's Jeopardy, followed by Who Wants to Be a Millionaire at 2:30. Then, as always, at 3, it's Dr. Phil. Please be sure to stay with us then for the CBS 58 News at 4. This Sunday is Autism Awareness Day at Miller Park. How your ticket will help support efforts for acceptance and inclusion for those with autism. And you'll meet the national anthem singer, Eric Look, and learn about how music helped him break through the challenges of autism and connect with the world. That's today, coming up only on the CBS 58 News at 4. He's a great guy. We've been following him for years now. He's really grown up on the air, so I thought it was something viewers would really like to share.
Yeah, definitely good to see good news coming in.
All right. Well, thanks so much for spending part of your afternoon with us. Please be sure to join us again tonight for the news at 4 and 5.